Now, Jeff, what do you think about what she just said? You know, that she was going through a tough time and that, you know, this man was a friend of the family. She reached out to him.
Yeah. Well, maybe her father was not in the picture. Mm-hmm. This is a person who was not a blood relative. So, of course, it's something that can be a little bit unsettling. But it seemed that this man, DiMaggio, really worked his way into this family and therefore, in many ways, put himself out there, becoming the confidant. Mm-hmm. And I would say it was not appropriate what he did. He should not have become the confidant to this girl against her mother.
Now, there was a moment during the interview and she was very poised and self-possessed, but where she did break up, she did choke up when she talked about her mother and her brother, both of whom were horrifically mm-hmm. murdered by mm-hmm. DiMaggio. Let's listen.
He had a really big heart and she was strong-hearted and very tough. She knew how to handle things.
Now, of course, you know, she wants to talk and she feels that people don't understand her side of the story.
Yes.
But do you think she's fully wrapped her head around what happened here? It's got to be impossible for anyone.
I think what happened was she came out of the gate a little bit too soon. I'm not criticizing her in any way by going on to the social networking, putting her...
Right, where she answered questions
exactly,
from random people.
Putting that information out there. She wasn't ready for it. And I think in some ways it may have retarded, if you will, some of that grieving that she should have had in her own personal time. And so now we see the grieving process happening right now. And there is that survivor's guilt that I think she still has not processed as yet, and that is inevitably a part of anyone going through something so horrific.
Do you think we will ever know the full story of what happened?
I think eventually we will. As she gets older, more mature, she feels more comfortable in saying what it is that really happened. And there are a lot of things that happen that I would guess from a clinical standpoint that she just cannot, either she's not talking about it privately, mm-hmm. but certainly she's not ready to talk about it publicly.
And she didn't talk about it in this interview, the events during the kidnapping. I mean, that was
That's
off
right.
the table
That's
per
right.
se.
And,
so
and
I'm not
I
holding
look,
that back from all of you. It's just
right.
she didn't talk about it.
Exactly. And I would hope no one pushes her in that way. This
right.
is something that has to be done clinically and with the love and support of her family.